In support of the International Day of the Elimination of Violence Against Women on November the 25th, and in observance of the accompanying 16 days of activism against gender-based violence, the Secretary's Office of Global Women's Issues is encouraging sustained efforts to prevent and address gender-based violence in all of its forms around the world. The Secretary has so often said, "Women's rights are human rights, and human rights are women's rights." Gender-based violence is not solely a women's issue. It affects all of society. It affects families. It affects men and women, boys and girls. It is a development issue, a humanitarian issue, a security issue that truly does affect each and every member of society in its implications. The challenges cannot be confronted by women alone. NGOs and civil society actors, for example, are working to prevent and address gender-based violence by engaging men and boys. And we have so many excellent examples from around the world, and I would like to mention just a few of them. The Independent Commission for People's Rights and Development is one important program supported by USAID-funded Garima Project to mobilize hundreds of men and boys from low-income rural communities in Rajasthan and other places to address the problem of violence against women through street plays and performances. While I was in India last November, I first became acquainted with this program. I had the opportunity to watch male members of the Rajasthan community perform a very powerful street play that addressed the terrible impacts of child sex selection, domestic violence, and child marriage, as well as sexual harassment that was occurring in their community. And what struck me about the performance was its ability to explain in a very compelling way why behavior like this is not proper or moral, and what terrible impacts it has more broadly. The message of the performance resonated throughout the community, from the women and the girls, to the men and the boys, to young and old, to all the individuals who were unable to read or understand in more formal ways. And the performance has had the ability to change the ideas and beliefs that are often perpetuated in places and that perpetuate violence against women. It spread awareness in the community and turned boys and men into champions for the cause. Everyone was empowered. In India, there is another program that is working with boys in schools to provide a curriculum on behavior that is improper, including violence against women and girls. In Senegal, Tostan, another program that works at the grassroots level with advocates and community activists, is doing extraordinary work in the villages. It is a Western African NGO headquartered in Senegal that has successfully partnered with male and female community leaders to provide education regarding the harmful effects of female genital cutting, for example, among other issues that Tostan works on. Their methodology is a proven one. It centers on respect and places villagers in charge of decisions, and it has been extremely effective. By helping to foster the collective abandonment of female genital cutting, Tostan's programs are allowing community members to share the knowledge they gain with their neighbors, friends, and family members. And their successful effort has created a lesson without borders, because today the methods they are using to ban FGC in their villages are being transported to other countries and being equally successful, because the solutions are coming at the grassroots, at the community level. millions of women and girls who have been subjected to this terrible practice and continue to suffer its detrimental effects are no longer plagued by this practice because the communities have voted broadly not to engage in it any further, where they have collectively come to understand why this is a terrible practice that harms the women, how it is degrading, how it offers other solutions to a better life. In Brazil, on the other side of the globe, a number of NGOs are using innovative channels to promote gender equality and end violence against women. Promundo, for example, engages young men and women in critical reflections on gender norms and attitudes. This important work has led to positive changes from improved partner relationships to decreased incidents of sexual harassment and violence against women. In Afghanistan, some of the religious leaders now are incorporating sermons about the need to combat violence against women. They are doing this in their Friday prayer services. They can be very persuasive voices in their community about raising awareness on the need to stand up against gender-based violence. We are working on programs to address violence against women all over the world. The United States is working bilaterally and multilaterally to define gender-based violence not as solely a women's issue, but one of international human rights. We are taking action on the ground, training peacekeepers on gender-based violence awareness and prevention activities, working with NGOs to ensure men's engagement in preventing violence against women, and partnering with religious leaders of all faiths to incorporate these messages into their outreach. The economic empowerment of women is also an integral element to any sustainable approach to eradicating violence against women. Studies show that women who control their own resources, who are able to add to the income of families and make a difference for their families' livelihoods, are much less vulnerable to being targeted because of their gender. These 16 days offer an opportunity to renew the commitment to freeing women from violence everywhere. Whether the abuse occurs in the home behind closed doors, in open fields of armed conflict, or in so many other ways. Countries cannot progress when half their populations are marginalized and mistreated and subjected to discrimination. When women are accorded their rights and afforded equal opportunities in education and health care, employment and political participation, they are better able to lift up their families, their communities, their nations, to be true agents of change. Secretary Clinton has noted that investing in the potential of the world's women and girls is one of the surest ways to achieve global economic progress, political stability, and greater prosperity for all people the world over. So thank you for all that you're doing in supporting ending violence against women, because it truly is a global epidemic. It occurs everywhere, and it has terrible consequences on the human rights of each and every woman and girl who is subjected to abuse, but also on economic productivity, on health. It increases the alarming rates of increases to HIV/AIDS, particularly among adolescent girls, when they are subjected to race and sex rate. Rape and sexual abuse. So I urge each and every one of you to do all that you can to use this time in a way that will truly bring an end to violence against women. Thank you for all that you do, and thank you that you will do in the months and years ahead.